by video, stand by audio, stand by lighting. We are recording in 5, 4, 3. Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Most of you know me from your field trips here at the Charleston Gaillard Center. For those of you who don't, I am Colin, the stage manager. And today we are filming from the stage of the Martha and John M. Rivers Performance Hall. Joining us on stage, a crew member you probably haven't met yet, Riley, the tech dog. High five. All right. Today, I'm going to show you some of the different parts of this building that make up the stage. We will also learn how theater technicians like me use specific instructions to get around the stage called stage directions. Under my feet is the stage floor. It's a wood floor, like some of you may have in your home, but in the theater, we paint our wood floor black. We like black in the theater because when we have people singing, dancing, or acting on stage, the black floor doesn't distract the audience from the performance. Is your floor at home black? Probably not. That's also why, as a technician, I wear black clothes like these. So I'm not distracting either. The floor is not always black. Sometimes we paint it other colors or put covers down like Marley for dancers. We have even covered the stage with sand to create a beach. Our stage is in a proscenium theater. We call it that because at the spot where the audience meets the stage, we have this giant archway that goes up and over and back down to create a window for the performers on stage. What I recommend is that you search for pictures of proscenium arches. I bet you will find hundreds of examples of big, beautiful, ornate arches from all over the world. Over the stage, we have a whole bunch of pipes, cables, ropes, and pulleys. When you take all those things and you put them all together, you have a system. In the theater, we call this type of system a fly system. You know why we call it a fly system? Because we really do make things fly. We make curtains fly, we make lights fly, we even make people fly sometimes. So, we have the audience out there in what we call the house. We have the proscenium to create a window for the audience to look through. And we have the stage floor for artists to sing and dance and act on. And we have the fly system to decorate the stage with lights and curtains and backdrops. So, when we have all those people on stage, like actors, and we have all those people in the house, the audience, we need to know where everyone is going, correct? That is when technicians like me use stage directions. Where is your left? Okay. Where is your right? Okay. Now, you need to remember your left and right, and also know where you are in the theater. So, I am on stage facing the audience, correct? Well, because I am on stage facing the audience, stage left is to my left, and stage right is to my right. Now, stage right and stage left stay right where they are. So when I turn around, stage left is to my right, and stage right is to my left. What? I know it's a little crazy. It's that way because no matter where you are standing on stage, you can always ask one person to go stage left, and it will always be the same spot. Then you can ask another person to go stage right, and it will always be the same spot. Okay, so we can go from stage left to stage right. But what if we want someone to go from here to there? Now, Riley just went upstage and I'm standing downstage. Hold on. I know what you're saying. There is no up or down. The stage is flat. We call it upstage and downstage because way back, they were on an angle, or what theater technicians call a rake. A rake stage made it easier for audiences on a flat floor to see the performers. As time went on, we made the audience sit on a raked floor, and the stages became flat. Now we can combine all four directions to create stage directions. Upstage left, upstage right, downstage right, and downstage left. Now you have the base knowledge to become a theater technician, or even an actor, singer, or dancer. It was really good to have you all back in the theater at the Charleston Gaillard Center. Thank you for joining us for our introduction to Stagecraft. Our remaining videos will dive into more detail on how we use your science standards in the technical theater world. You will also have a chance to meet the rest of our crew. Riley and I are heading down below the stage to work on some equipment. And while we do this, have you ever wondered how we make things disappear from stage? Sometimes we take a ride on a lift. See you again here soon. Good job, Riley.